Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'd like just to focus on the last words of Jesus, which he says, is perseverance. Because like now, those who are in celebrating their birthdays, we do know that they're meant to do in their lives. So likewise, in our lives, our Lord Jesus reminds us today that this is what is truly important, because he is to remain faithful and living what he has taught us and persevering it until the end, when he will call us again to his own way of living with his eternal life which is in heaven. So as the church ends the liturgical, faithful children of God, because that's the only way that we can truly be able to look forward to our future, to persevere what we have decided to do. So to all the birthday celebrants, we wish them well, hope that they will continue to persevere whatever they have to do in their lives. You know, that what is for all of you, what you ever have planned to do, that the Lord will continue to grant you his love.
Thank you.
you, Lord, with all the angels in their song of joy. Holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Holy indeed, the fountain of all holiness. Let your Spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, the death he freely accepted, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup again. He gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed
on the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Without surrender, be on good terms with all persons. Speak your truth quietly and clearly, and listen to others. Even the dull and ignorant, they too have their story. Avoid loud and aggressive persons. They are vexations to the spirit.
If you compare yourself with others, you may become vain and bitter, for always there will be greater and lesser persons than yourself. Enjoy your achievements as well as your plans. Keep interested in your own career, however humble. It is a real possession in the changing fortunes of time. Exercise caution in your business affairs, for the world is full of trickery. But let this not blind you to what virtue there is. Many persons strive for high ideals, and everywhere life is full of heroism. Be yourself. Especially do not feign affection, neither be cynical about love. For in the face of all aridity and disenchantment, it is perennial as the grass. Take kindly the counsel of the years, gracefully surrendering the things of youth. Nurture strength of spirit to shield you in sudden misfortune, but do not distress yourself with imaginings. Many fears are born of fatigue and loneliness. Beyond a wholesome discipline, be gentle with yourself. You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here. And whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Therefore, be at peace with God, whatever you conceive of him to be. And whatever your labor life, keep peace with your soul. With all its sham, drudgery, and broken dreams, it is still a beautiful world. Be careful, be happy, and make others happy.
Because that I am just right now having jet lag and escaped from the Philippines, to thank Father Rudy for doing the homily. We just told him to do the homily. More years in their lives and lives in their years, and with God's blessings. I hope this gathering will not only be ended in this mass, but as we say in our Filipino language, after pagkatapos ng misa, merong mesa. After the mass, we have the table.
I tonight, Christos, alam patunayan, wawal na
ganito ko na lang dito. Come on, dance with Auntie Marte.
Thank you.
Oh, It's not your birthday. What are you all doing over there?
I want the other servants to know it's beauty before age. That's why I'm going first.
Okay, sir, I'll take your picture.
Hey, Cora! This is Antonio Banderas. Ay, nako.
I sure hope so.
Check is in the mail.